What's happening, guys? Todd here. Today I have a review of the recently released flash card for the Neo Geo, the Neo SD. The version I have is for the MVS arcade boards. I should also mention at this point that this card is not a review unit sent to me by the Neo SD team, nor was I in any way compensated for this video. I paid for this unit out of my own pocket, and this video represents my own thoughts on it. For all practical purposes, the Neo SD works just like the EverDrive flash cards for other video game consoles. ROM files are copied to an SD card and then inserted into the flash card, which then loads them into memory and plays the games. The Neo SD is compatible with all commercially released games and even homebrew stuff too. The Neo SD consists of two PCBs that are sandwiched together and interconnected with standoffs. The board has 768 megabits of flash memory, which is enough to store the largest commercially released Neo Geo game. There's also an ARM CPU and two FPGAs to take care of the flash card magic. There's a microSD slot that allows for SD and SDHC cards up to 32 gigabytes, which is more than enough storage for the complete library of Neo Geo games. If you're wondering about a cartridge shell for the exposed circuit boards, they hope to have it ready very soon. The Neo SD is available for both the MVS arcade boards and the home AES console. The MVS version costs 380 euros and the home console version runs 436 euros. So that translates into about 397 US dollars and 456 US dollars, respectively. Before you can use your Neo SD, you have to first use the Neo Builder tool to convert your Neo Geo ROM zip files over into the .neo format. This is necessary because it uncompresses the zip file and decrypts the ROMs to allow for loading on the Neo SD card. However, this tool is Windows only, so no Mac or Linux version. I used it in a Windows virtual machine on Mac to convert the files. You then copy the .neo files to your FAT32 formatted microSD card, pop that into your Neo SD cart, and then boot your system up. I have here my one slot MVS board plugged into my Supergun. Boot up the system and you should be greeted by the Neo SD logo and then the game selection menu. Navigating the front end of the Neo SD couldn't be easier. Pressing your joystick up and down scrolls through your list of games, while pressing the joystick to the left and right scrolls through entire pages of games, allowing you to quickly find the game you want to load. Underneath the list of games, you'll see a picture of the title screen of the currently selected game, and to the right, some basic information about that game. Underneath this, you'll see the A, B, C, and D buttons on your controller all have different functions. Pressing A will load a game, and pressing B will then go into the options. Let's take a look at the options screen. From here, we can set the boot mode, which tells the Neo SD to boot to either the currently flash game or the Neo SD menu. The in-game trigger option, which when pressed will exit the game back out to the Neo SD menu from your controller. There are several different button combos which this can be set to. The system mode option allows you to force either MVS or AES system mode. This is disabled when using Unibios. With region, you can force a specific region or just use the BIOS default. Arcade mode is for when you have no microSD card present in the Neo SD, the menu will be disabled. Basically, it makes the Neo SD act like a standard game cartridge. Save, restore, back RAM. When this is enabled, the MVS backup RAM of the current game will be saved to the microSD card when switching to a different game, and restored back when it's loaded again. The user interface sounds is pretty obvious what this does. You can turn it off and on. Version gives us some details about the Neo SD, like serial number and firmware version. Let's go ahead and load a smaller game like Cyberlep. Press A to begin the flashing process. As you can see, this is not an instant process. The larger Neo games can take several minutes to load. If we hold down A plus D and then press start, we can go back to the Neo SD menu. At the top of the screen, the very first option is launch current game. If we select that option, at the bottom of the screen, we see the currently flashed game as Cyberlip. Press A and the game is instantly loaded. No need to reflash the game again. Let's exit back out and load a larger game. Let's flash Mark of the Wolves. This game took nearly 4 minutes to flash. I have sped up the video of the game loading to save time.
vengeance. But here, they do not exist. Only winners and losers here. For here, the mighty.
Backing out to the Neo SD menu, there are two other options to bomb the screen. Pressing C will filter the games by genre, favorites, and all games, and depending on what button C is set to, pressing D will toggle the favorite flag off and on and cycle different game genres. However, with the current shipping firmware, these two options are broken and do not work correctly. There's a beta firmware that is in testing that has been reported to fix these issues and also speed up flashing time substantially. Hopefully that firmware update will be released soon. If you're wondering why you should buy the Neo SD when there are multi-carts like the yellow 161-in-1 with most of the Neo library on it, the answer is simple. None of the different multi-cart versions have all the Neo games on one cart, therefore you need to buy multiple cartridges. And more importantly, many of the games on those multi-carts are buggy with missing sounds, graphics, beta game versions, and other issues. You can build your Neo SD ROM set with known good working Neo ROMs. If you have a Universe BIOS in your Neo Geo, you can even CRC verify the ROMs against original cartridges to know that you have good working Neo Geo ROMs. Not only is the Neo SD compatible with the Universe BIOS, it is also compatible with the Neo SaveMaster and Virtual Memory Card. I can wholeheartedly recommend this flash cart for Neo Geo fans. Even though the price of entry is high, once you consider what some of the games are selling for, the Neo SD will look like an absolute bargain. I also hope that this will encourage more homebrew games to be developed on the Neo Geo. Well folks, that about wraps it up for this review. Whilst there are a couple firmware issues to be worked out, from what I have seen from the Neo SD team, they're quick to respond to any queries that folks have and are hard at work ironing out any remaining issues. If you like this video, you know what to do. Give me a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, feel free to leave a comment below. I'd be interested to hear what you had to think of the Neo SD flash cart. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.